Jeff. I am an ESL teacher, and today I will explain how English has become an international language. More precisely, I will answer this following question. How did a language spoken by 4 million people on an island in the north of Europe become a global language in less than 400 years? I will first briefly expose the current situation of English in the world. Then I will speak a little about its origins. And finally, I will explain how it went from a marginal language status to the world's number one language in so little time. What does it take for a language to become global? Two things. First, it must be learned as a second language in a majority of countries. And second, it has to be used as a common language in some important domains in the world, such as commerce, science, and culture. English indisputably fulfills these two conditions. Let's check out some stats. Right now, more people speak English as a second language than as a first language. Actually, English is currently spoken by more people in Southeast Asia than in the US and the UK combined. We should also point out that many more people are currently learning the language than there are people who speak it well. So the situation is not about to change. According to the British Council, in the world right now, 1/3 of the books are published in English, 2/3 of scientists read English, and 80% of electronic communication is done in English. Moreover, English is the common language of several international domains, such as science, business, popular culture, international diplomacy, and aviation. During my trips in the last 15 years, I was able to measure this stunning progress myself. By the way, in the world's history, other languages also qualified as global languages, such as Latin and Greek, and to a lesser extent, French, Spanish, and Arabic, but none of them ever reached the dominance English is currently enjoying. Now, let's review briefly the origins of English. The first speakers that will become English were not the first inhabitant of the British Isles. Before them, there were, among others, the Celts and the Romans. And a few years after the departure of the latter, in 410 after Christ, the first Angles and Saxons landed on the island. And then, for more than 1,000 years, that is until the late 1500s, English evolved but remained isolated within the island. Here's the question I'm asking today. What happened afterwards? What provoked the explosion of this language? I will propose two answers. One simple and one more complex. If, for example, you are asked this question at a cocktail, I suggest you choose the short answer. To make it simple, we can say that English is now a global language because Great Britain is an island. Indeed, while other European countries were trying to expand their territory by invading their neighbors, England, being an island, had no choice but to cross oceans to conquer new land. In order to achieve that, it capitalized on its fleet and eventually gave birth to one of the biggest empires in history. The turning point of the history of English occurred when the British fleet defeated the so-called invincible Spanish Armada in 1588 under Elizabeth I. That was the short answer. Of course, when you go deeper, you see that many factors played an important role in the expansion of English. First, as I just mentioned, there is the British Empire, which was the largest empire and the first global power in history. At the peak of its power, it included 1/4 of the world's population and more than 1/5 of the Earth's total land. Inevitably, its linguistic heritage was enormous. And what proved crucial for the future of English is the emergence of American power, even as the British Empire started to decline after the First War. That event enabled English to keep its momentum and reach the position it's now enjoying. In addition to these two global causes, which are the British and American empires, we can point out 6 specific factors that help give English its global status. In chronological order, there is first the Industrial Revolution, which by starting in England gave this country an important economic advantage. Second, we can mention international commerce, which was Great Britain's strength for a long time thanks to its colonies and industrial power. Third, we must not forget the two world wars, which were won mostly by English-speaking countries. After the Second War, the Marshall Plan particularly gave English a boost in Europe. Next, in recent history, two major events made English spread even faster. First, the fall of the USSR in 1991 made the US the only superpower. And second, the dazzling growth of information technology since the mid-90s has turned English into everybody's second language on the web. Finally, we must also point out the amazing power of attraction English-speaking popular culture has internationally. In conclusion, we can see that the history of English is a real success story. Indeed, the story of a language that went from 4 million to 2 billion speakers in less than 400 years is almost real. My presentation also highlighted one important fact. The popularity of a language has nothing to do with its inherent character, but rather depends on the power of the people who speak it. Thank you for watching this presentation, and see you soon.